play a lot of card games with my kids. We go to movies. My son's starting to get to the age now where he wants to spend a little bit less time with dad and a bit more time with his friends, but we do occasionally. He plays on the guitar, I play a bit on the piano. You know, the time is precious, but it's being a father is the best experience of my life.
Conservative government is expected to crack down on file sharing today by tabling a bill.
Introduction of government bills. Mr. Prentice, seconded by Mr. Van Loan, moves for leave to introduce a bill entitled An Act to Amend the Copyright Act.
Most draconian copyright acts anywhere in the world.
What it would mean is that if you buy a CD or a DVD or even your cell phone, your ability to use some of those things, if they're locked down, would really be restricted. So if you had a CD, say, that was copy protected and you want to listen to that music on your iPod or your iPhone, suddenly you'd find that you're an infringer if you try to transfer the music.
Stephen Harper's come out and said that he believes that the reporters on Parliament Hill are biased against his government, so he's not planning on dealing with them anymore, just won't deal with them.
They don't ask questions at my press conferences now, so, you know, we'll just get the message out on the road. The press gallery at the leadership level has taken, an anti-conservative view.
But there were hardly any reporters in sight. Why? Well, because about two dozen of them walked out on the PM when he refused to take their questions. You see, Stephen Harper does not want to hold news conferences unless his staff can control who can ask the questions, and they want to do it from a list that they compile.
Now, there was a time in the hardline Conservative Party that the independence of MPs, the idea of their being free to speak for constituency above party, was a sacred notion. The old Conservatives of Reform put the strength and independence of backbenchers as the number one need of our democratic system. Mr. Harper revoked that notion fairly brutally with his full-gauge dismissal of Bill Casey yesterday, and looked, to my eyes anyway, all too pleased to be acting the party boss rather than the broad-minded leader. This is the trouble with Stephen Harper. His keen tactical sense, his partisan victories, like the New Deal at Nova Scotia the morning after the Williams rout, often gets canceled out by the sheer relish he evidently gets from declaring who's in charge. Without Bill Casey's actions, there wouldn't have been a deal to announce yesterday, and Casey didn't deserve that chilly smack from his one-time leader.
Jaws dropped from coast to coast because in the last election campaign, Stephen Harper repeatedly said that a conservative government wouldn't tax income trusts.
When Ralph Goodale tried to tax income trusts, don't forget this. They showed us where they stood. They showed us about their attitudes towards raiding seniors' hard-earned assets. And a conservative government will never allow either of these parties to get away with that. And a conservative government will never allow these parties to get away with that.
It was a central part of the Tory election platform. On page 32, it clearly states, preserve income trusts by not imposing any new taxes on them.
The G8 summit is over, but there's still plenty of talking about one contentious issue, climate change. Developing countries are making it clear they don't like the plan laid out by Prime Minister Stephen Harper and the rest of the G8 leaders. It calls for worldwide greenhouse gas emissions to be cut in half by 2050. And the Prime Minister says developing nations will have to do most of the work.
You know, we did a focus when we've done the Clean Air Act, and as we implement our Clean Air Agenda. The focus is a little different than the other parties. They focus only on so-called greenhouse gases.
Welcome back. Well, a controversial new bill that critics claim would open the door to government censorship is now before the Senate. The bill is C-10. It's a tax bill amendment, and it would change guidelines on tax credits for movies and television programs.
Here's what I think about this bill. It's afraid of ideas in that the government tells you what they think they're comfortable with, and so you then don't ever get a chance to see this film because it never got made.
A kind of censorship already exists de facto. I wouldn't call it censorship. What happens is that some movies are rated in a way that precludes younger people from going to see them if they're considered to be inappropriate for that age group.
very quietly late last night, the Natural Resources Minister fired the head of Canada's nuclear safety watchdog. Today, Gary Lund faced opposition outrage and charges of what it called blatant political interference.
I think when ordinary working people come home, turn on the TV and see a gala of a bunch of people, you know, at a rich gala, in a rich gala, all subsidized by the taxpayers, claiming their subsidies aren't high enough when they know those subsidies have actually gone up. I'm not sure that's something that resonates with ordinary people.
We are the product of generations of government support that has given us a pretty secure sense of what culture means. But that's going to change. That is being threatened. And I think that what my concern is that once those institutions begin to get dismantled, they will not be put back up again.
If you were a vegetable, what type of vegetable would you be and why?
I would choose, if I had to instead, to be a fruit, just what I am, sweet and colorful.